It is extraordinary how technology has transformed our whole lives. I remember those days when, not so long ago, the only way to communicate same day was by telex. A mobile phone was 10 feet tall and would have a life of 2 seconds. And now, through BlackBerry, you can take your whole office on holiday with you.
I remember the first time I travelled abroad with my parents, it was Paris on the hovercraft, and I thought, wow, this is fantastic, this is the transport of the future. And that may have been a bit of a red herring, but when you look now at how easy it is to travel around the world and the speed with which you can do it, it really is quite amazing.
I remember travelling back and forth to Prague back in 1994 when I first went out there. It was quite a custom of mine to be able to get through passport control quicker to give a little gift to the custom man or lady. And I used to bring over a box of chocolates or a bag of Mars or Kit Kats. And I'll never forget, after about 2 years, the lady who was a regular through the VIP channel gave me a Kit Kat as I went through. And that's when I realised times are changing.
Our money has changed too, and it's travelling as far and as fast as we are.
We have a common market, we have a common trading market, we have in most of the Western countries a common currency in the euro, but what we don't have is a common property market. Planning is different, legislation is different, there are so many different areas of supply and demand which are different in different phases of a cycle, that there are these anomalies which investors can not only exploit, but actually generate long-term benefits from those.
Global capital markets are increasingly giving flight to intricate cross-border deals.
We identified a portfolio in Holland, the Vastgoed Mixed Fund portfolio, which was basically 34 assets in 30-odd locations across Holland, about 145 tenants and approximately 200 million in euros in lot size. And although we have a strong internal team here, we needed a good local advisor to help us do the underwriting and the business plans. So it was very natural for us to link up with Cushman and Wakefield. We know them really well. We know they have the local market knowledge. And we know that in this particular incident, they had to be very efficient. We had to close the portfolio, basically go unconditional within 4 weeks.
I was in contact with the vendors and the vendors' agents, picking up on the typical Dutch sort of hints. And colleague Steven Screen was liaising back to the client, interpreting those signals, which led to a full understanding of what the vendor and the vendor's agents were looking for.
The Curzon deal was a living embodiment of a cross-border deal. UK-based client, French mother company, Netherlands-based portfolio, and American money through the financing. Nothing more cross-border than that.
In 2004, the appetite for cross-border investment in Europe totaled nearly 40 billion euros.
The question of who's investing and where they're investing really has no end, because everybody is investing and they're investing in all of Europe. The biggest investors, without doubt, in Europe itself are the Americans and the Germans, and the main targets have been to date the UK, France, Spain and Sweden.
But while investors may be willing to explore new markets, their demands for accurate market intelligence are immovable.
Europe Capital is a pan-European real estate investment business which invests money on behalf of its clients, and we have used the services of Cushman & Wakefield in many countries, really from Spain to Scandinavia and from the UK right across the Czech Republic. And part of their breadth across Europe is what we like. They've assisted us with the transactions, with due diligence, with research, and I guess the reason we come back to them is we think they've got integrity.
We have a local office network that literally stretches the globe. The sun never sets on Cushman & Wakefield. We have a system which enables proper communication and exporting of best practice between offices. It is equally motivating for our capital markets teams in Paris to help our capital markets group in Milan or Russia. And in that way, we work together for the best interests of our clients.
The weight of capital available in Europe now has some investors questioning just which markets are cheap and which are overpriced.
It does depend on what your home market is. I think certainly in the case or the experience of many UK investors, they recently have felt that perhaps it's difficult to find value in the UK, and European markets may appear cheap. In some cases, I would agree with them. There does seem to be some value out there. At the same time, the local investor might not necessarily share that view and might not quite understand why their market is particularly cheap. And I do think that's one of the advantages that cross-border capital may have, being able to comparatively buy across Europe and perhaps to stand back and see the value that, you know, the local investor doesn't quite perceive.
That hunt for value is seeing investors look further east as yields compress in Central Europe.
We acted for DB Real Estate in acquiring Park Atriums. It's a 26,000 square meter office building let to ING. They put it into a fund which has three office buildings within that fund, one in London, one in Paris, and Park Atriums in Budapest. And the reason for putting those three buildings together, and particularly for including the Budapest property, was to provide a higher yielding property within that fund. You've got the stability of the income, the cash flow for a long time from the London property with its long leases, but in Budapest you're getting higher yield.
But that success is no accident of fate.
They'd bought two office buildings prior to that. They'd been in the market for several years and they'd done their homework effectively. They've also been looking at the new accession countries, and those are exciting markets which investors really ought to be evaluating now. The important thing is to take local advice and to know what you're doing.
Of course, it's not only the Europeans who are looking to shop abroad.
The investment markets in the US refer to the abundance of capital as the perfect storm. And you have three major groups looking for additional investment opportunities beyond our domestic borders. And they're looking in the major centers in Europe and in Asia. And we are in all of those locations, and we provide introduction, we provide analysis, we provide strategic investment direction, and ultimately we provide execution.
Equally, China's position as a viable haven for foreign investors looks increasingly assured.
The real opportunities in China are on the development game. The local developers are facing a cash crunch nowadays because the local banks have gone soft in terms of lending. Therefore, there are more and more opportunities that are coming up for investors to invest.
But of course, the ultimate driver of global capital is finding the next big thing.
Well, Russia is the next hotspot because our clients think it is. And they're all here. And they're all growing. And the demand for the service and the real estate world in Russia is tremendously high. And not just that our clients are there, the companies that still do not know the business of real estate are starting to understand the importance of it. And that's fueling the growth for our business, for our company.
The GDP growth in Russia has been 6 or 7% annually, year on year. And the price of oil up has given some very good fundamentals to the overall to the Russian economy, which is fueling the growth of the middle class, the middle market, and they're demanding goods and services, which is propelling the growth of shopping centers, businesses, jobs, the need for office buildings, warehouses, transportation, everything.
So in this world of constant change, what can we expect of the future?
My wish for travel for the future would be to utter the words, "Beam me up, Scotty."
I have actually glimpsed the future, courtesy of my four-year-old son and the Lego models that he makes for me. And if transportation is even a fraction like he suggests it's going to be, it's going to be a fantastic future.
I know what will endure at Cushman Wakefield is the quality of our people, our relationships, and our culture of working together.